This short lesson shows the use of chromatic scales as part of your improvisation sequence. The first thing you need to do is play something to improvise over, and in this case it's a C7th to a G7th chord, but only part of the chord, that is the third and the seventh of each chord. You do not want a big fistful of chord, because the more notes that you have in the chord behind the improvisation, the less flexible you can be with the notes that you put in during the improvisation. The bass line will take care of the root notes of the chord, but in this case I'm not playing the bass pedals. Playing bass pedals will be covered in a later lesson. A great practice aid is iReal B application that runs on an iPod, and it allows you to put in backing tracks, or you can type in your own sequences. It also allows you to repeat the sequence up to 30 times, so you can just leave it running and practice away to your heart's content. Start the rhythm with the left hand, and then play chromatic scales with your right hand. At first, play ordinary chromatic scales up and down the keyboard. Select a speed that you're comfortable with. The fingering for the chromatic scales is clearly shown here. A lot of jazz and blues licks are chromatic scales with certain notes missed out or repeated. It's a good idea at this stage to try fitting in the figure that I showed you in the last lesson. During this practice session against the two chords, it's a good idea to use what is known as a blues scale, the blues scale being C, B flat, G, F sharp, F, E flat, C. Practice it slowly at first, then attempt to speed it up. It's most important to be accurate on these runs and fills. The thing about Hammond organs that's interesting is the improvisation style can be very relative to the sound that you have on the keyboard. This is the stereotypical Jimmy Smith sound you hear, with the first three drawbars all the way out, third harmonic percussion with fast decay, on percussion volume soft, not forgetting the wonderful vibrato chorus in the C3 position. This Hammond has just been played in my studio, so it doesn't really have the volume level required to make it distort. I don't wish to go deaf at this stage, so it's played fairly quietly. When you crank it up, then it has all the rest of the niceness of the Hammond organ, or nastiness, depending on which way you look at it. Thanks for watching, I hope it's been of some use to you.